What's going on, guys? This is Riggs. Thank you so much for tuning in to this video. This is an important one. What I want to do is kind of break down everything as quick as I can. I don't want this video to get too long. Plus, like you guys already know, I'm on vacation, but I have to get this video out because there is a huge update that is right around the corner. There's some stuff that's not important, but there's a bunch of stuff that is important that could be huge game changers. And I kind of want to just explain a couple things. I want to try to touch on everything, but some stuff we're going to blow through quickly. Some other stuff I want to spend a little bit of time on explaining and breaking down. So, you know, like, comment, and subscribe, you know, if you guys enjoyed this video. But yeah, this is going to be the 0.13.5 update. So there have, like I said, some big stuff is coming. And we'll go ahead and jump right into this, you guys. Starting off, this is probably the biggest one. And this is the team deathmatch is coming. So, and what's interesting, this has been out for a while on the Chinese version, but it's coming to the global version. And not only that, but it's going to be available in third person and first person perspective. Why someone would want to play this in third person, I'm not 100% too sure, but for those of you that are big first person perspective players, this is going to help. It's going to help your reaction time. It is going to help how you play this game, your accuracy, communication, working with your team. It's a 4v4 deathmatch. I believe it's the first team to 40 kills wins the match. And it's right around the corner, you guys. So definitely, this is going to be a huge game changer for a lot of people. And the cool thing is, so you can actually use, those room cards to play in team deathmatch. So I think that's going to be epic, for tournaments, you know, just having fun with your friends. Maybe we can, you know, do a couple on here. So, on this channel. So that's going to be the big one. There's also been a feature where you can change the controls from first person to third person. Why someone would have their controls different? The only thing I can think of is probably the lean and peek option. You really don't need lean and peek too much in third person. In first person, it's crucial because you got to be able to peek, you know, around corners and things like that. But yeah, you can have different controls now. This is a big one. It says they've upgraded third-party app prevention system and enhanced detection of cheating behavior via virtual app emulators and modifiers. So this is huge. They also made an announcement that they are continuing their strive to, you know, make PUBG Mobile a fair play game, where they're continuing those, you know, decade-long bans. So what I've noticed, and other YouTubers have noticed, is there's more hackers now than ever, and that was after the ban they just did. So I'm really hoping that, you know, they continue, you know, to keep PUBG Mobile a fair play game. Another one they've added is an MVP showcase system at the end of each match. The patch notes say, it says all players will receive a default MVP post. The top three players in classic mode or the MVP of the winning squad in TDM will also be featured. TDM as in team deathmatch. So basically just a new pose as opposed to the ordinary. Everyone is just there, you know, at the end screen at the end of your game. Whoever gets MVP has a special pose. Game changer? No. Is it cool? Yes. Now, this is also a big one, you guys. In Vikendi, players will now leave footprints, trails, and tire tracks on the snow. So not only could this change the strategy a lot of people have, but, you know, leaving like a trail of breadcrumbs behind them. But when I read this, the first thing I thought of was, for those that have low-end devices, what this is going to do to their device. Will it affect it? I don't know. Is it likely? Probably, because, I mean, your device is going to have to work that much harder, especially like on the PC version. If I'm not mistaken, I think footprints last like something like 8 to 10 minutes. So, you know, for me, you know, I have a Note 9. For those of you guys that have like newer iPhones, it's probably not going to affect you as much. But for people who have low-end devices, That could definitely, you know, have some wear and tear on their device. So I'm curious how that is going to be, something I'm just going to have to monitor. This is another interesting one. It says added a dedicated button for climbing that can be enabled in the settings. Right now, when we climb, like we climb through a window, if you're kind of climbing or jumping onto a rock or a ledge, you're pressing the jump button. So I guess that's not going to be a thing anymore. Now there's actually going to be a dedicated button. So hopefully this, by adding this dedicated button for climbing, hopefully that's going to fix like the accuracy of jumping through a window. Because right now you got to be pretty much dead center if you plan on, you know, jumping or climbing through a window. So again, something else we'll have to just kind of monitor. But I'm hoping that that's going to fix the jump button issue. This is also a very important one, you guys, at least to me. It says in the patch notes, when killed by friendly fire, now players can decide if the teammate should lose merit or not. This is perfect for someone who's getting killed on purpose, like with a grenade or with a Molotov. Those will kill you. There is no real, it says friendly fire, but you can't like friendly fire. You can't, I don't even think you can run a teammate over anymore, and you can't shoot at a teammate, but you can molly them. And you can throw a grenade at them on purpose and kill them, which has happened to me actually quite a bit here in Season 7. I can think of 3 occasions where it's happened on purpose. So now, it's much different than if you're like clearing a building and you're running up to the second floor and your teammate's throwing a nade on an accident and you run into the nade and then you get knocked. It's like, oh damn, you know, that sucks, I got knocked. This is for when it's intentional. So I'm really glad that they're adding this. It'll make the someone's merit that much more accurate, because the people who are doing this maliciously, are now gonna, now they're gonna pay for it, because if you lose your merit, you can't play squad matches. So kudos to PUBG for adding this feature. Another cool one that they're gonna be adding, which I'm actually kind of excited about, is they're adding a Godzilla theme. It's gonna go great with the crates, with the movie that's out. I actually plan on seeing it in a couple days. But yeah, they're adding a new Godzilla theme. Godzilla theme lobby background will be available together with mini themed events and rewards after the update. Just kind of something fun. It's always nice to kind of get, a new theme, kind of freshens up just kind of the overall vibe and atmosphere of the game. And I think a lot of people in general are kind of excited. Godzilla's badass, and it goes great with this badass game. This says add a new popularity gift and ranking reward system. So that one we're not going to touch on too much, but they do have a new ranking reward system. Millions of people play this game, but if you're in like the top 100 of popularity, you'll, stand out that much more. It also says they've added a charisma ranking. The permanent outfits and firearm vehicle finishes collected by a player will increase their charisma. So the more, the more money you spend, the more charisma you'll get, and they'll have a new ranking reward system for that. They also have some new achievements, all dealing with the team deathmatch. We won't cover that too much. I don't want this to be a 30-minute video. There also have been some new changes coming to zombie mode. So, just some changes to the liquid nitrogen grenade. They're taking away some old zombies, bringing in some new ones. They're bringing in some new bosses, and they also are adding a brand new building to the survive till dawn zombie mode. So there is going to be a new building that has better loot, but more enemies or more zombies protecting it. They've also made some improvements to the inventory. Just some quality of life stuff. I'll just go ahead and read it real quick. Players can now combine items in batches. Equipped items will be displayed on top. I thought that was already a thing, but it is in the patch notes, so I'll let you guys know about it. Duplicated new items will no longer be indicated by a red dot or the new tag. For someone that has OCD like me, who likes to get rid of all the red dots, that's going to be kind of big. Also says the backpack and helmet tabs have been moved to the customization tab. Some other quick changes that are going to be coming before we wrap this video up is the arcade mode times have changed. Mondays and Wednesdays, sniper training and war. Tuesdays and Thursdays, mini zone and quick match. This is a really cool one. Friday through Sunday, so basically the weekend, all arcade modes are now going to be available and all times are in UTC. That's going to be cool, because right now on the weekends, especially for people who are streaming or people who only play on the weekends, sometimes all the arcade modes aren't available. So that's going to be a big benefit for a lot of people who play arcade mode. This is another big one I wanted to touch on, which is very important. And this is players... this one right here. Protective items are now 25% more durable. Their effectiveness remains unchanged. This was mentioned in the patch notes before, but I wanted to break it down so it actually makes sense, because the way they word it here does not. So what this means is, let's say you have a level 2 helmet on and you get hit in the face with a car 98. Not only do you get knocked, but your helmet is gone. Now that's no longer gonna be the case. Same thing with an AWM. If you have a level 3 helmet on and you get hit in the head with an AWM, you're knocked and your helmet is gone. What this means now is the effectiveness remains unchanged, meaning when those two scenarios I just mentioned happen and you get knocked, you're going to have a helmet on now because the helmet is more durable. The effectiveness, meaning what happens to you, does not change, meaning you're still going to be knocked, but you're still gonna have some of your helmet left. So that'll help, because you're gonna still have some protection for in the event you're able to get revived and get bit, you know, get picked back up. You'll still have your helmet on and ready for the fight. As of right now, that does not happen. You're that much more exposed when you get hit in the head with any of those weapons or an M24 or, you know, any of the, you know, any weapon that knocks your helmet off. I want to touch on that real quick. Players can now bolt/reload a bolt action rifle while moving instead of completing the process while aiming down sights. This one doesn't make sense to someone like me, because whenever I get a headshot or if I knock somebody using a bolt action sniper rifle, immediately once I know that I've knocked them, I always undo my ADS. It's just a natural reaction. Why, you know, this is there, I'm not too sure. Maybe after you knock somebody, someone's just pressing reload and it'll always rescope very quickly. But for someone like me, who just naturally, just muscle memory, takes off the ADS, that isn't, you know, that's not like a thing. It says improve the animation of FPP when running while holding an SMG. The only thing I can think of that this means, I know like when I have an SMG versus a sniper rifle or an AR, or a pistol, when I have an SMG, the weapon takes up like the entire bottom of the screen. I'm hoping that's what they mean, because that will also be a huge quality of life and actually a big game changer in itself, because you'll actually be able to see more of your screen. For those of you, especially someone like me who's actually playing FPP a lot more, that's gonna be huge. Hopefully that's what that means. The sounds of explosions are gonna be changing. It says vehicles now have improved feedback on explosions, so that's interesting. There's also been a big change to the crew challenges. So as of right now, you can only do 2 matches per day. That's gonna be changing. Now you can do 3 matches per day. I think that is huge. And before, I think there was only, it says now 6 qualifying matches will be held every day, when before there were 5. So they're gonna add basically 1 more hour that you can get matches in. And now there's a squads can participate in a total of 18 qualifying matches. Before, that was only 12. So they are making some big improvements, kind of extending the time that you can play and being able to get in 1 more match, because sometimes only playing 2 matches, it just seems like it just goes by so quickly, and sometimes you can't play every single day that the crew challenge is available. So being able to squeeze in a whole extra match, 3 as opposed to 2, that's going to be huge. As we get to the bottom here, it says players can now collect all rewards from daily missions, progress missions, and achievements all at once, just another low quality of life. And they've added 3 new clan insignias for level 7, 9, and 10. And last but not least, added latency indicator to the main screen. Yellow, green, and red represent a good, average, or bad connection. Because as of right now, when you're on just the interface or the, you know, just the starting screen of the game, you don't know what your ping is. Now you will. Before, you'd have to actually go into a game or at least get into the lobby. The main people this would affect would be those like playing in places you're normally not, where you don't know what type of connection you have. But again, just a little quality of life improvement. But that is pretty much it. We pretty much covered everything that, in my humble opinion, is important that's going to be coming to the 0.13.5 update. As you're watching this video, it could possibly already be out, or it's going to be out, should be around midnight UTC time when it gets released. So let me know what you are most excited about. Some big changes that are going to be coming. One thing that I did not see, and hopefully you guys have made it this far into the video. Before I wrap it up, one thing that was not mentioned in the patch notes about anything were the bugs and the glitches. Nothing about the one-shot glitch. Nothing about the hill glitch. Nothing about desync. Nothing about the biggest one, the newest one. Nothing about the delayed loot spawn. You know, if you're one of the first ones down, there is not loot. You could run over three ARs, go upstairs, go back downstairs. The enemy's already come into the building, and they have a barrel of M762 and a Kar 98 that did not spawn for you. These need to be fixed, especially when they're going to be adding something like footprints. Whenever the last, I think, three, maybe four updates, every single update that has come has brought a new bug or glitch. I'm curious, what's going to be the new one? And I've yet to see any of these new bugs or glitches get fixed. So I pray and I hope that some of these bugs are going to be disappearing. The last thing anybody wants to see is a new bug show up into the game where we have all this cool stuff, but you're not able to, you know, play the game like you're supposed to, especially with PUBG Mobile getting into esports. They got to step it up. They got to start fixing these bugs and glitches. Leave a like if you agree. Subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Comments, questions, or concerns, again, let me know in the comment section what you're most excited about. Hopefully this video has not gotten too long and you enjoyed whatever gameplay I was able to scrounge up to put into the background. But I got to get back to my vacation. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Until next video, this has been Riggs from Riggs Gaming.